Hey, Carla.
Hey, are we ready to paint rocks or what?
I think so.
I bet we're going to have a big class today.
I hope so. We'll see.
Yeah, what's going on?
Not too much. I watched Hamilton over the weekend, so now I'm like rocking out to the soundtrack all the time because it was awesome.
Wasn't it awesome? I watched it on Friday night, and I love that so much. Love it.
So good.
So good. It is, and it's weird how they, I heard before I saw it in New York, and they said, oh, you've got to listen to the soundtrack or you won't get it. I got it perfectly. The words, you can understand everything.
Oh, yeah.
It's amazing, though, how many words are in that.
I know. And it was, we just had the captions on our TV, like, all the time, basically.
Yeah.
So it was kind of nice, because, like, I think, I had to rewatch the opening song like once because there was a lot of groundwork laid in that opening number. But oh my gosh. And then he circles back. Like there's so many different themes that he circles back. Like the writing of it was really just.
It's amazing. Amazing. I mean, he did a lot of research to do that movie.
Yes, I'm sure. I'm sure he must have. It's just.
And, you know, I don't like rap or anything. I didn't even like that. And I loved that. I mean, that's probably one of my very favorite musicals. After I saw it, it was one of my very favorite ones. But I'm tired from this weekend. Are you tired?
Am I tired? No. I think it's because I'm riding high on adrenaline. Like, I'm just really excited for this week and, like, the end of the week to come.
When do you get to go?
So we're going to try and leave, like, after work on Thursday.
This Thursday?
Yeah, this Thursday.
Okay.
And then I'm working remotely from my mom's house on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of the following week. We're just getting up there.
Okay. Yeah. Whatever. How long is it going to take you to get up there?
About 3 days. So
are you talking about your trip to Michigan?
Yeah.
Oh my God, 3 days. That's long. How many hours?
It's about a 20-hour drive. And we have two littles. So, you know, it's either drive at night, which Robert and I are both terrible at that.
I don't like to drive at night.
Night people, we can't stay up.
Like,
not safe.
Rock me to sleep.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, as soon as it starts to get dark, I get a little sleepy. So that's just not safe. And so we just break it up into 3 days. And the girls, or Kaya at least, loves staying in hotels. So we're just.
Oh, perfect. Dan, you've sort of mapped it out. Joellen, I just made you a co-host, and I'm making you a co-host.
Okay, thank you. So I'll take attendance, Carla. Do you want me to watch the chat or
could you just watch chat? Yes.
Pay attention to hands and all that kind of stuff.
Same old thing. And okay. Admit if people come in because they usually, you know, straggle in.
Okay. I'll watch that too.
Liz, do you have anything you'd like us to do special for you today?
No. If you'll maybe help me with spotlighting people. So Joellen, I'll just kind of give you the rundown. I'm going to welcome people and pray. Then I'm going to take a poll, you know, just, you know, raise a hand, see who's done any rock painting before, had a pet rock. Then I'm going to talk about three different kinds of rock painting, and then we're going to begin painting.
Okay.
And so I'm kind of going to give them some steps, and then I'm going to just showcase what my hands are doing. And I figured after a few minutes of that, we could just kind of spotlight people's progress if anyone's painting along. And then, yeah, and then go back to painting some more and just talking about what I'm doing, why I'm doing it, and then we could spotlight more progress. And then, and I'm going to kind of go over some rules for kindness rocks, like, you know, asking your neighbors before you throw them in their yard so they don't tear up somebody's lawnmower, you know, just things. Good, you know, community consciousness, and then we should be done.
Okay. So. I've never spotlighted before, so.
I can do it, but let me ask Liz one quick thing. Are you going to spotlight yourself? Do you want to do your own spotlighting so when you're ready, you'll spotlight yourself?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, I can do that.
So Joellen, when we spotlight, like when we call out people to say, oh, let me show us your rocks or whatever, you do, let me see how, up at the upper right corner, there's those three dots.
I see it.
Yeah, and then you say spotlight video.
Okay, and they have to be unmuted before you spotlight them.
Yeah, so okay. If they need to talk, then you unmute them, then spotlight them. And then when they're done, cancel their spotlighting.
Okay.
But we can do it. No big deal.
Sounds good.
Cool. Did you watch Hamilton this weekend, Joellen?
You know what? Tim and I started to, and I feel like you have to be fully awake so you can hear and understand. Yeah. And we couldn't figure out how to put on the closed caption, the subtitles.
That's so that is helpful. Yes.
Yeah. I'm going to start it again, but I need I need to know I have like the complete 2.5 to almost 3 hours just for that. Yeah. I'm so excited though. Leslie watched it. We're actually borrowing her Disney Plus account, and she said it was fabulous.
So good. And in New York, the stage, the way they do the stages, there's these turning. It is so good. And the choreography is unbelievable. So
I love the costumes. I mean, they're just.
Oh, the costumes. I love it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that King George, is he the best? I know.
I about died his first song, just laughing like
the whole time.
Then.
And he comes every time.
Favorite
he comes
characters
back.
Behind George Washington.
I loved it. Loved it, loved it. That's one of my very favorite plays.
Did you see it live? Like on Broadway?
I did see it live. My brother-in-law saw it like before it was famous. Yeah. So he got tickets before it even came out. And he paid like $150 a ticket, you know, whatever. Yeah. And he was like on the third row next to like movie stars. So he really got it. I saw it after, not with Lin-Manuel, but they were just as good. I mean, it's really incredible. We were like on the fourth row, really good seats.
It's so heartbreaking to think that Broadway.
Did you see that guy, Nick Cordalis, today? That guy from Broadway passed away. 40s, one baby, healthy.
Yeah.
Passed away.
Oh my gosh.
Terrible. He just gotten married and had a baby and
he died from COVID or what?
And he was healthy. It's just weird how some people get it. You just don't know.
Yeah.
There's not a one size fits all for this virus.
Sadly. No, I don't think anyone knows.
No.
Yeah.
No. On that note, I'm gonna do class with my mask on.
I love it.
They can talk
to the
computer, right?
All right.
Okay. Douglas, the girl Smith. What's the girl's the name that's Smith? That she does all of Stephanie's stuff. You know.
Jessica.
Huh?
Is Jessica here?
Jess Smith. She's in. Luke, Nicholas.
There we go. Luke.
Who's Who's Susie Riggs?
Susie Riggs?
You know her?
I mask.
Think I know her.
I don't. Nancy, Appleman, Leah, Max, Ben.
Carla, I have to tell you that, and I almost sent out a group text message for this, but when Madeline prayed about how much she loves Zoom and that she just looks so forward to them, and what a great gift you're offering these participants who haven't seen each other. It's just, it's wonderful. So I know you put a lot of work into this.
And they're in Santa Barbara, if you can believe that, this week. They got there. I'm so happy. They have a house. They're not staying. They're not eating out or anything. But she said, now, Carla, I'm going to be gone next week. I'm going to try to do classes, but I'm not sure. I said, Madeline, you don't have to do classes next week. It's fine if you cannot do them.
Yeah, it's just been, I know it's a hassle and it's not, you know, the preferred way, but I'm telling you, it's just such a gift for these families, and it's been wonderful. So
yeah, I mean, you know, we reach more people doing this for sure. We're reaching many more people. But,
well, and just in taking it, inputting attendance. I mean, I used to input like 3 or 5 people.
Yeah.
So
look at us.
It's great. It's really great.
I know. I just get tired of being at my house, and if my dog barks, Joellen, I'd mute.
Okay.
Just know if I'm muted, you need to.
I need to.
Get you out of way.
Okay. All right. It's 2 p.m.
All right.
It's 1 p.m. Excuse me.
Is it 1?
It's 1.
Should we let people in?
Yep, let them in.
All right.
I'm not on my own computer, so it's harder for me.
Hey, everyone.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, everyone.
Hey, Emily. Hey, Nancy.
Oh.
Hey, Will and Belinda.
Oh, good. Yeah. Hi. Will was
asking me
today.
Hey,
Nicholas.
Hey, Nicholas.
Hey, Efren.
Hey.
How are you?
Good.
Oh, look at them all.
LG, how are you?
This is Leah.
Hi, the Wolfie. Hey, too.
Jess is here.
Funny how much she's learned with
hey,
this.
Luke.
She probably knows a little bit more than me. Knows how to scroll over.
See everybody.
I've got you set up here, Allison.
Here.
Here's your paintbrushes. Here's your props. If you need
Nicholas, you have a whole crew with you today.
Yeah.
You need to tell her that you're
That's pretty cool.
And Maya Allison is here too.
Really? Oh, cool. Hey.
Hey, Allison.
Hi,
there's Will. Hey, Will.
Can you say hi?
Hi, Will.
So you can see a little bit better, and it shows your face a little bit better. And it stands up.
Me.
Would you like?
It's nice to be able to follow him.
And Emily, hi.
Go ahead and do. Let's get some of the colors ready.
Water.
A big flat page.
Yeah, we'll probably give everybody about 1 more minute in, and then we'll get started, y'all.
Actually, I have a question for.
See, we're not doing the phone. We're getting the sound from my phone. So
what's up, Jess?
I'm trying to close that.
Yes, a question.
Liz is in charge.
Don't do anything to my phone. It's this. That
you know what? I'm thinking everyone should mute yourself.
Okay.
From you?
Go ahead.
You know how.
Go ahead.
Then
what?
She said you're dead.
And if you don't, we'll do
a lot of backlash.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
I said we're supposed to have 10 rocks.
Emily and Luke, can y'all mute?
Oh, 3.
Ben, do you want to mute?
I don't know.
See, I've never done this with it. She told me to do
it. I'll do Ben. Thank you, Ben.
LG.
She doesn't want the sound from your
Susie.
At all. She wants the sound from my cell phone.
What? I don't see LG.
LG.
Oh, there you are, LG. There we go.
I don't see Max, but I see his name.
Yep.
Okay. Trisha is really Ashley. She's coming in.
Okay.
There she is. Hey, Ashley.
Hey.
Say hi.
Hi, Ashley.
Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
Okay.
All right.
How are you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Good.
Hannah's with us.
Okay.
Jess, did you have a question for Liz? Yeah, go ahead, Jess. Can you unmute yourself and you can go ahead and ask?
Yeah, go ahead and ask your question.
It's not for Liz. It's somebody else. Who? It's Jolene is the one who I seen her before at the Y.
Yes, I saw you at the Y. Yep, we used to work at the Y together.
How's it going lately?
I have not been back to the Y to work, no. Not yet.
I'm not there anyway.
It's okay. Yeah. Good to see you, Jess.
Well, it's good to see you again.
I'm excited for this class.
Yeah. I like the big class, Liz.
You.
All right, friends. Well, it's almost 5 minutes after one. You guys ready to get started? Thumbs up? Awesome, awesome, yep. Awesome. Okay. I'm going to pray over our class real quick, and then I'm going to spotlight myself, and we'll go ahead and get started, all right? Heavenly Father, thank you so much for all of those gathered here together with me over Zoom. Lord, I pray that you would bless our time together, help our creative juices to flow, and help us to spread a little kindness today. We ask all these things in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right. Okay. All right. Can everybody see me? We're good? So, rock painting. I would like to take a really quick poll, actually, and see, has anyone ever rock painted before or ever had a pet rock? So just raise your hand if you've had a pet rock or you've painted rocks before. You hands, LG, I see you. Okay, Ashley. Yeah, a few other friends. Okay, cool. Well, some of us haven't. Luke, you've had one. Nice. Okay. Well, cool. So today we're gonna actually paint two different kinds of painted rocks, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. But we also there are a few different kinds that you can do. So today we are going to start off by making a little tic-tac-toe set.
Waffle.
Bugs. So I'll show you how to do this.
Waffle. We're gonna
bumblebee and ladybugs. And if you make five each of them, then you have your own little tic-tac-toe set. If you don't want to do bumblebees or ladybugs, you can do like monsters or just like two different sets of colors of rocks. And you could make, and if you do five red rocks and five blue rocks, you could have your own little tic-tac-toe set. Then you can also, on your own time, there's a thing called story stones. And so we're not gonna go over this today because these can take some time, but these are really fun. So these are some that I've painted for my kids actually. So this one's of a tree and this one's of water. Here we have a campfire. And so if you have cousins in your life or nieces and nephews or kids in your life, what's really fun with these is you can put out some of the stones and together you can build a story with someone. So you could say in our story, we're gonna have a tree and a campfire and maybe like a little firefly, and you just can build a story by using your rocks as kind of story prompts. So that's story stones. And then the other one that we're gonna do today is kindness rocks. And so these are for, so if any, I know I asked you to collect a variety of rocks. Kindness rocks, we're gonna do towards the end, and I would save your biggest, consider them to be your kindness rocks, okay?
It's just on my phone.
Are things that you kind of put out in the community secretly for other people to find when they're going for a walk with their family or by themselves, and they can have little words of encouragement on them or just something bright and sunny and colorful. The idea is that when someone finds a kindness rock, hopefully they feel kind of inspired or uplifted, or that you made their day a little brighter and a little happier. So we will be making a few, if you brought a bigger rock or two, we'll be making one or two of those today as well. So to get started, I'm going to show you guys where I'm working. And so I'm gonna get started on the bumblebees and the ladybugs. And then after a few minutes, we'll check out your progress. Okay, so I've got red paint here. I'm using an acrylic paint. So I'm gonna get a little dab of that. And I've got some yellow paint here for my bumblebee. And I'm gonna put down a little dab of that. Okay, and then I've got some black paint here for my details. And we're gonna get a dab of that. Okay, so I asked everybody to bring three brushes if you have them. If you don't, if you only have one size brush, you can work with that too. I have three different sizes here. I'm gonna start off with my base coat on each rock, and I'm gonna use my biggest brush for that. All right, so I'm gonna start off, and I'm gonna make some red ladybugs here. You can see my rocks. And I have, just for future reference, I've found these rocks in my yard, and I washed them and made sure that there wasn't any loose dirt on them. Okay, so we're just gonna get some red paint going. And we're gonna paint this guy. I like to paint the whole rock, but you can just paint the top of the rock if you want to. Just depends on what you wanna do. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna paint all the base coats first, and then we'll put the details on later when it's dry. We got one there.
Liz, why do you have to use acrylic paint? Why can't you just use any kind of paint?
You can use tempera. So if you're using tempera, that's okay. I like to use acrylic because it doesn't wash off nearly as easy.
Does it wash off your hands and brush easily?
It does come off your hands and your brush, but it tends to stay on the rock without being sealed.
Okay.
Pretty darn well. Whereas tempera, like these guys, these story stamps, these were painted 2 years ago
with
acrylic, and that's held up really well. And my daughter's been kind of tossing them around and playing with them and stuff. So it's definitely possible to use tempera, but just my experience with tempera is that it tends to come off a little easier, and it's very, very washable. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I got mixed up.
I think Hannah was saying that she only had big rocks, but you can make big bugs too, right?
You can make big tic-tac-toe rocks. You absolutely could. Absolutely. Making them smaller just means that you can transport them easier. But no, you can absolutely do this with big rocks too. Okay, so I've just got three ladybugs started, and now I'm gonna do my base coats on some bumblebees. Get those going. I like to blot my brush after I use it. So I've got a cup here with water, and I'm dipping it in the water to rinse off the red. And then I like to blot it on the paper towel just to get rid of that excess and to know that it's really nice and clean before I go to my next color. We got the yellow going on.
It looks like a lot of people are painting right now. Mm-hmm. Nicholas.
That's awesome.
LG, he's painting. Look at that, yeah.
I think Will is. Yes.
Hey guys. So with tic-tac-toe, I'm guessing everybody's probably played some kind of version of tic-tac-toe. Your best bet is to have, you can play with as little as 4 pieces per person, but in order to completely fill out a game board, you know how it's a grid? It's best if you have 5 pieces. So I'm just kind of going to do 3 and 3 for examples today, because I don't want everybody to get bored. But if you have time on your own, I would suggest that you finish out 2 more of each different kind. Does that make sense?
Oh yeah, LG's got his going. Yeah, he's got it going.
Do we want to spotlight some people? I'd love to. LG's working on.
LG, can you unmute yourself and I'll you can show you what you've been doing. Can you unmute? Ah. Okay, LG, unfortunately, you're bigger before you're unmuted. Can you show your rock?
Yeah.
Here we go. Yeah.
Oh, there you are.
It's just a small little rock.
Uh-huh.
The other side I put purple. It's trying to do yellow, but the other side is turned yellow.
Very
oh,
nice.
How nice. Perfect. Perfect.
And
thank
then
you.
Eventually, I'm going to paint black, give it some eyes.
Oh, perfect. Good idea.
Awesome. Awesome. That's exactly where we're going next, LG, is eyes.
How about someone else? Anybody at the Nicholas household want to show us what yours are? Let's unmute first, Nicholas. And I'll do it. I think I can do it. Well, maybe not. I'm having so much trouble with that. You get it?
Let me try.
Okay.
Maybe we're fighting each other on this. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Okay. Nicholas, you ready to spotlight your rock?
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
Did we spotlight Nicholas? I can't see yet.
No, I got him. He looks great.
Oh, good. Okay.
Nice.
Look at that. Look at that pretty red rock you painted. Very nice.
Perfect.
Very
nice.
Awesome.
I think Jess is ready to show hers. Jess.
All right, Jess, let's see what you got.
Well, actually, I can't paint rocks.
You can't paint rocks.
I can't paint rocks. It's harder for me.
Okay.
But I'm trying to find a way to write things or to like an arrow or something. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. Everyone has to do the same thing.
Okay. Well, good. Does anybody else want to show off their progress?
Yes, they're going to show you. What?
Let's see here. Anybody else want to show anything?
How's Ben doing?
Ben is painting away. Oh, Ashley is. Ashley's getting ready to share. Ashley, can you unmute yourself?
There you go. Uh-oh,
no picture now.
There we go.
Oh, man.
Okay, so, Ashley, I'm gonna make it big so you can show.
Hey, Ashley.
Wonderful.
Good.
Good. That's got her ladybugs going.
There we go.
Oh, man. Sorry, got a little pain in my finger.
Hey.
That's all right.
We're not alone.
It comes out instead. Thank you, Ashley, for showing us.
Hi.
Okay.
Okay, Liz, you're on
all
again.
Right. Are we ready to move on? Are we ready for the next step?
Yep.
Okay, I'll go ahead and I will highlight myself and we will, I'm getting paint on the computer.
Hope it comes out easy.
I know, it should. Sorry, let me get my spotlight back up. All right, friends. So we're going to add some detail. Everybody can see my little yellows and my little reds here. We're going to add some detail to our ladybugs and our bumblebees. So my ladybugs, my red ones are nice and dry right now. We just did one coat, so I'm going to start off with them. So you're just going to kind of pick a part of the rock that you want it to be the face. So I like kind of picking kind of a narrow part, and I'm going to start with my black details first. So I'm not going to put anything on the area I've designated to be the face. I'm going to decorate the rest of it. So I like to give my ladybugs two little wings. So we're just going to do two little semicircles. Can you? Yeah, y'all can see that. We're going to go like this. And we're going to go like this right here.
Is that black paint, Liz, you're using?
Black. Yes, yeah, sorry. I'm using black paint. So just ring. Kind of looks like a funky looking basketball right now. And then I'm going to start drawing my yellow circles because everybody knows ladybugs have spots.
Mm-hmm.
Some distinct. Just however you want to do some little however many spots you want to give them. Give them some spots. Doesn't have to be even. Okay. So that's one. I'm going to move on to my next ladybug, and I'm going to do all my wings and spots all at the same time. And if you don't want to do the wings detail, you can just fill the body portion of the ladybug with spots. They don't have to have the wings detail. It's whatever you choose. Okay, where's the head on this one? Maybe there. We'll do our wings. Oh, that one got a little wonky.
That's all right.
That's what I love about these classes.
It's just everything is good.
Everything is good. All right. So I've got my spots and my wings on my ladybugs, and I'm going to move. I think these are looking pretty dry because I'm going to continue to use the black paint, and I'm going to move on to my bumblebees. Okay. Bumblebees are really easy. We're just going to do little lines. Again, you want to pick out where your face is going to be, and you're not going to paint where the face is. You're going to kind of go down where their abdomen would be or where their body would be, and you're just going to draw little black lines. Okay. See that? And let's see this guy. He's kind of a funny shape. We're going to do like this. And some black lines. Across his body.
There we go. Those are cute.
And the last one. That one's still a little wet. We'll see.
I love playing tic-tac-toe. It's such a fun game.
It is. It's a neat one. And it's so easy to do. All right. We've got our black detailing. Now I'm going to rinse my brush again. And I'm going to keep using the smallest brush that I have that you feel comfortable with using, because we're doing some detail work. If you're doing this on your own and for some reason you have googly eyes at your house, instead of painting your eyes on, you can glue googly eyes on. That's another option, but I wanted to keep the supplies low and minimal, so I'm not using googly eyes. We're gonna do it with paint. So I'm gonna go get some white paint, and I am gonna do, so down where I picked out my face for each one, I'm gonna back this up, sorry.
Perfect.
This is the face of my ladybugs. And so on each side of the face, if you will, I'm gonna put a white dot. Decent size white dot on either side. Okay, and I'm gonna do the same thing with each of my bugs. White, 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 and white. Okay, and I'm gonna do all the eyes at once. So now that the ladybug whites of the eyes are done, I'm gonna move on to my bumblebees. And I'm coming up to my last one here. And that's all in the face area, wherever you've chosen you want the face area of your rock to be. Okay, so now they've got all these blank little white eyes. I'm gonna rinse again, gonna rinse my brush. Okay, and I'm gonna blot it. Get all that water off. And then I'm gonna go back to the black. I'm going to get my black paint, and I'm just, so when I do this, I like to just get the tip, the very bottom tip of my paintbrush with the black, because all I'm going to do is I'm going to basically drop it on the white of the eye. So just one small, I'm trying to, I hope you guys can see this.
I can see it.
Okay, good.
Oh, no, I can't, but it's all right.
No, I can't. Did I cover it? I'm sorry. So I
just it's all right. It's hard to do.
Left a dot. And see, now they're friendly little eyes. They're not so blank and white anymore. And you just put one little black dot in the center of the white dot. One little black dot in the center of the white dot. And they become a little funny looking.
It looks a little hard, Liz. Is it hard?
It's a little challenging, yeah. If you're using a bigger rock and your white circles are bigger, then it's a lot easier. Having a small brush is helpful. And like I said, if you're not painting along with us and you happen to have googly eyes at home, or you want to run out to the craft store and get googly eyes, that's also a fun option for these guys. So how's everybody doing?
Let's see if anyone wants to show some. Who wants to show some? Do you wanna make a big grid here? Let's do that. Let's make a big grid. Yeah, let's see. Who's gonna show us? Leah wants to show. Leah, can you unmute first so we can hear you?
That is a J.
There you go. Show us, Leah.
Leah, that looks great.
That's a J.
Very nice.
Nice.
Leah, fabulous.
We see them every morning.
I love it.
Do you see them on your walks, Leah?
Yes.
Wonderful.
They're flying at you.
Nice.
Fabulous. Thank you.
Where's the J's?
See who else? Luke, you were doing them just a minute ago. You want to show some, Luke? You want to unmute first? Okay, Luke. I'm gonna make it big. We want to see your rocks. Let's see. Okay. Oh my God! Oh, you got big, nice rocks. Very nice.
That's great.
Yeah, I love those big ones too, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fun. Ooh. And that one's got red eyes. I dig it, Liz.
Great job.
I see that Abby's been working away. Abby, what are you working on?
Abby, unmute yourself. Can you do that? There you go.
So I have a ladybug, but it's red with gray stripes. And then a bumblebee. I don't have a yellow, but I have a pink bumblebee.
Ooh.
And it has dots on it and some green stripes.
Very nice. I love it.
I hope that's okay, though.
Oh, it definitely is. Definitely is.
Thank you.
Awesome. Would anyone else like to showcase their TikTok pieces?
Ashley has her hand raised.
Okay, Ashley, let's see you.
Let's get her unmuted first. I am having such a hard time with this mute. Unmute.
There you go. Do you see me?
Yeah, we got you, Ashley.
I did white, black, and red, but I don't have any yellow.
Okay. That's all right.
Oh, beautiful.
I love those eyes. Well done. Oh,
very good eyes.
And my rings.
And wings.
Rings.
I see that.
Love that, Ashley.
Nice. Way to get
that. Thank you. At my house.
Great. Awesome.
I miss you, Liz.
What?
I miss you.
Oh, I miss seeing everybody in person too. I like being able to see people. It's just not the same. Not quite the same. All right.
I went swimming.
Great.
But that's why you have a white senior.
Do you have a pool at your house?
No, we don't have a pool.
Okay. Some people do, you know. That's awesome. All right, my friends. Well, like I said, Six, I'm gonna go ahead and re-spotlight myself. Six is a little light, six to play tic-tac-toe. So we're gonna move on to kindness rocks now, but you'll just use that same technique. If you wanna make a full tic-tac-toe set, I would suggest you add two more bumblebees and two more ladybugs. Maybe after we're done with class or some other time. So I'm gonna move them off my screen. And we're gonna move on to kindness rocks. So kindness rocks, cool thing about them is they can be any color combo you want. We're thinking bright and colorful. I think I'm gonna maybe go with, I'm thinking blue. I like a blue rock with some fun colors on top of it. So we're just gonna pick out whatever color you want. And we're gonna do a base coat. And if you wanna make more than one kindness rock, again, just pick whatever base colors you want them to be. And we'll just do the base coats on those. And yellow. And then while you're doing that, you might start thinking about, what you wanna put on your kindness rock. If you wanna put like a symbol on it, like a heart or a star, or if you have a phrase that you like I like the phrase, be kind. Or I know I'm seeing say like God loves you or Jesus loves you. Those are really encouraging for people to pick up as well. Or just a symbol of a heart or a star, just our flower. Anything that you think might speak to your neighbors or even yourself if you were to find a random rock somewhere. Or if you want to tell a joke on a rock. You know, you could do that.
Liz, can you keep the rock when you find it?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. So if you see one of these, you can pick it up and keep it.
Yes, you get to keep it. Like this one that I was showing, we didn't make this one. We actually found this one when we were in Rockport. My daughter found it and she got so excited. It just totally made her day because she found kindness rock. And I will say in general with kindness rocks, if you do plan to actually leave them outside, before we go, we're going to go over some rules. But one of the things you want to do is if you're going to leave them outside, you're going to want to seal it with a spray sealer. I don't have any of that right now, but something like sometimes people have Mod Podge at their house. That's a good sealer. You can, I think, there's a spray paint brand that makes a sealer and you can just spray it on the rocks too. And the reason why we do that is because it will help the rocks stay pretty with your beautiful design on it until someone else is able to pick it up. And so that prevents the weather from kind of tearing it down and taking all the beautiful artwork off of it. I'm gonna paint my second one a bright yellow so it sticks out if somebody were to see it.
Are you going to take a walk with your daughters and leave some rocks out today?
I think so. They're at daycare right now. But we take an evening walk. And I think we'll deposit some rocks today. Make our neighborhood a little brighter place. Does anybody else take an evening walks?
I do.
Everyone is so busy painting.
I know.
Everyone's focused. That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Carla, have you seen the rocks out on your walks with your dogs?
You know what? I have seen maybe a few, but not that many. I would like to leave some, though. I like the thought of that.
That's a great idea. How about anyone else? Has anyone seen rocks out on their walks? I have not. I need to be looking.
You haven't seen any, huh?
Mm-mm, nope.
Bet you're gonna see them now.
Absolutely.
Hopefully we kind of help spread some joy, huh?
Yeah.
So I'm blowing on mine just to get them to dry a little bit. And then I'm just gonna add some of my own embellishments. I think I'm gonna kind of do a starburst on one of them. But like I said, you can do all sorts of things. Anything that kind of strikes your fancy that you think might help someone have a brighter, happier day. And I know with COVID business and everybody staying home, I think people can just use some joy in their lives.
Big smiley face on a rock is always fun.
Mm-hmm. Actually, on my blue rock, I think I've just decided I'm going to write the word joy in the middle.
Oh.
And I think that's what we're going to do. And I'm just going to do kind of a sunburst here.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty.
Yeah. We'll get when I write words, I'm going to use my fine point. If you're wanting to write words, I would suggest using your smallest tip, but you don't have to write words. Whoop. Writing is kind of tricky.
Todd's got a really pretty purple paint he's using. Are you using that on a kindness rock?
Who does?
Todd.
Oh yeah, I do see
Todd. Todd, let's see it.
Yeah.
Todd, unmute. Can you unmute Todd?
Todd and Nikhil, what are you guys do?
That's my favorite.
Yeah, here they are.
There we go.
Hey, Nikhil.
Hey there.
So, okay, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. They want to see what you're doing there.
Oh, beautiful.
Great job. Set it down. Set it down before you drink. Set it down first.
I love
Set
it.
There we go. Now drink.
Great.
Beautiful, Nikhil.
Keep wow. Talking.
We want
that is awesome. Keep it up, man. Jeez. Anybody else want to show off what they're doing with their green. Kindness rock?
Can you do just a little bit more green?
Jessica had her hand up a minute ago. Did you want to show us your rock, Jess?
I did one. All right. But I don't remember what I stood.
Showing
the whole thing.
Hey, that's really nice. I love the colors.
Very cool, Jess.
It's arrow.
Yeah, you said you were an arrow. It's great.
Nice.
Not bad.
LG's going to show his. LG's is pretty. It's purple too. Isn't it purple?
Let's see it, LG. Oh, nice, Jess. Thank you.
Yeah. I'll show you LG's, make it back there. LG, go ahead, show it again, please. Show your picture again. I mean, your rock.
Yeah, I paint I love you in purple.
Oh.
I'm trying to make a peace symbol after
the
glow, but it kind of mixed up.
That's great. Oh, that's going to be beautiful, LG.
Mm-hmm. Liz, when you paint on one side, when it dries, can you turn the rock over and put another special message on the other side?
You definitely could, yes. Okay. Absolutely. Absolutely. And the thing that I love too about these paints is that if, like when you're painting on the rock, if you feel like it's kind of going on thin or you don't like it, let it dry and mm-hmm. add another layer, and then that can really thicken it up and make it darker looking, and you won't see as much of the rock texture if you're not, you know, just depending on whatever kind of look you're going for. Mm-hmm. You can do different things with it. Okay, I can show y'all what I've got here.
Ben, did you want to show your rocks?
Oh, there he is. Come on, let's spotlight Ben's rocks here. Oh, look at that, Liz. Belong.
I love it. That is so great.
So good. Does he have the googly eyes on that ladybug?
I was going to say, he's got googly eyes. That's how it looks, guys. If Ben, will you hold up if I don't want you to ruin the paint job, but you've got googly eyes on your ladybug, and that's what it looks like if you glue them on. That's great.
So cute, Ben. So cute. Oh, he's got a whole sheet of them.
He does have a sheet.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Now, Ben, where did you find this? Did you go to a craft store or did your...
He's muted right now.
Ben, can you unmute?
Let me cancel the spotlight and then unmute him.
There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so I'm just had this like for a long time. It's in my in the drawer.
In the store.
In the drawer.
Yeah. You must be an artsy family.
I was gonna say y'all just have supplies on hand.
Sometimes it's fun to have extra supplies on hand.
Never have anything on hand.
Good deal.
Thank you, Ben. Everyone's just painting away, Liz.
What?
He has some big rocks that he's working on.
Who is?
Luke.
Luke is?
Yeah, I don't know if he wants us to see him.
Those are big.
They are.
You know who we haven't, oh, let me see. Oh, that is a big old rock. That's nice. Oh.
Nice.
Show him the other one.
Yeah, hold on.
Okay.
I'll wait.
You've got quite a few going there, Luke.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Did you see that table full?
Mm-hmm.
Luke, are you gonna leave these out or are you gonna keep them?
You gonna
hit
him out, please?
See, there's
your rocks.
Oh yeah, he's got lots.
Oh, cool, man. Very cool.
Oh.
So, Francis, is anybody else wanting to show theirs?
Let's look and see. Anybody? Oh, Nicholas. Nicholas.
Yeah, let's hear from Nick.
Can I mute first, and then we'll.
These ones are mine.
Oh my god. Oh, those are beautiful.
Whoa.
They're next.
See? It's Nick.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Very good.
Nicholas, are you going to leave yours out on a walk today or are you going to keep them?
Walk.
Okay. That sounds good.
You want a walk?
Yep.
There you go.
I love that.
I miss you.
We miss you too, Nick.
Bye-bye.
Francis, we continue painting.
I think Nancy's finally ready.
Nancy's ready? Okay. I want to see Nancy's.
I haven't heard from Nancy this time. Let me make it big. Okay, here we go. Let's look. Oh, look at that.
Beautiful.
Fabulous, Nancy.
Love that with the flowers next to the word joy. It's very happy. It's a happy rock.
In from the swimming pool. Anybody else? Anybody else have anything they want to show? Oh, Anna Lucia. Yeah, let's see Anna Lucia.
Yeah. What have you got going?
Here we go.
Oh, fun. With some purple and white stripes and dots.
Yes, I use the stripes.
Mm-hmm. I love it. You just made...
I use the stripes with the eyes. Yeah.
That's so awesome. So awesome. Yeah. Cool.
Thank you, Anna Lucia. Okay.
Awesome. Well, friends, it sounds like, Carla, do you see any other ones?
I don't see any of their hands. Oh, Todd, do you want to show yours? Unmute, Todd.
All right.
I got him.
Okay, thank you.
Let's see if I can get this so that you can see it.
Can't see the top. Let's see the top.
Do you have puff paint?
Can you see it?
Oh, that's neat.
Of course, that's, you know, Nikhil did the rock. Daddy did the...
Oh.
Oh.
I don't know if you can see this one or not.
Okay, okay.
Oh, yeah.
And then, does it say belong?
Yeah.
Cool.
Just like Ben Acker had belong on his, too.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to leave them out, Todd? Are you going to take a walk and leave them out?
What's that?
Are you going to take them out and leave them out on a walk or something today?
We'll have to see. This is actually the first time Nikhil has ever painted. So,
well, I mean, he did a great job. I think that'd
at be home.
Do that. Fabulous.
That's great.
So good. Well, anybody else who wants to show?
Are we done?
Let's see.
Like we're hard at work.
I don't see anyone raising their hand.
Okay.
Oh, oh. Hannah wants to show us.
Yeah, let's see Hannah.
Oh, she did joy on hers too.
I love that. We're going to spread some joy, y'all.
And I think that one says hope. I'm not sure.
Mm.
That says love.
Love.
Love. Sorry, it was me. Right, reading wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, Hannah, that's beautiful.
That's lovely.
The popular word, that word joy.
Yes.
Joy.
Awesome. Thank you, Hannah.
Leah said that she has left to collect more rocks.
She's gonna go ahead.
Oh, that's great. Some more.
Well, good job.
There she is. She is. She's
coming in now. If we, we've got plenty of time, so we can keep painting together and sharing what we're working on. But one of the things I wanted to share with you is that there are some general good housekeeping rules for if we are gonna spread some joy by putting our kindness rocks in our neighborhood. So a few things you wanna keep in mind in general with kindness rocks, you don't wanna glue on embellishments, right? So that would be the googly eyes and things like that. So if you did put on googly eyes, those are great for your tic-tac-toe set or keeping them inside your house or maybe giving them to a friend, not for leaving outside. The reason why is because with rain and wind and just the elements of being outside, glued on embellishments can come off pretty easily and then they become litter. And you know, we don't want to add any litter or garbage to our environment. So if you make a kindness rock that you plan to leave out in the community, please don't glue anything to it. Other thing that you want to remember is you want to keep the rocks in open spaces. But you don't want to hurt anybody's lawnmower. So when you are thinking of a place to put them, think of maybe like a garden bed or maybe an area where there's mulch or an area that you know someone's probably not going to just, you know, go over with a lawnmower, like right smack in the middle of somebody's yard is probably not a good idea. Also, in general, if you don't know your neighbors very well, I would recommend asking them before you leave a kindness rock in their yard. You never know. Sometimes people are a little sneaky about their yards. So if you don't know someone very well, then I might ask before you leave a rock in their yard. And then you don't want to put them in a place where they're really going to disrupt nature. So just as you're walking, just be mindful that you don't stick them. I don't know if you would find like a bird's nest. Don't stick it in a bird's nest, right? We want to let the birds do their own thing. I don't think any of you would do that anyways. But you just want to be mindful when you're putting out your kindness rocks so that they're not disruptive, but instead they can be inspirational unkind like we want them to be. So those are just some things to keep in mind. And if possible, you can seal them as well, like I told you earlier.
This hurts.
Oh yeah. These are mine that I came up with. So we did joy. You guys saw me working on that earlier. And then I thought we could do a happy day.
That's cute.
That is cute.
So just different things that you can do and work on. Does anybody have any questions?
Jessica has a question.
Go for it, Jess.
Raise your hand up.
There you go. I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
On this one, do you think I should put like a name on it or something? Like something simple?
Yeah.
Like peace on earth or world peace?
Oh, either one I think is a great message.
I'm just thinking something for my aunt.
Okay. Well, you can choose whatever you think that she would like best, because you know your aunt better than any of us certainly do.
So I'm just asking, should I put
you said anything.
Anything in particular, like wood piece?
Yeah, sure.
Go for it.
That's a great message to share right now.
Okay, I was just asking.
Yeah.
You have good ideas, Jess.
Definitely. And guys, the neat thing about like the tic-tac-toe set or like what Jess was doing with the kindness rocks, these are a neat thing that you could give as a gift to somebody. You know, it's homemade, it's from you. If that's, you know, something that you'd like to give as a gift, it's really unique and it's pretty fun. And I think your friends and family would probably get a kick out of it.
I have a question, Liz. If you wanted to complete your tic-tac-toe set, what do you suggest, cardboard or paper, or how would you make the actual board?
You could do it in a variety of ways, because if you want to transport your set, you could just get like a plastic bag, and you could put, you could actually even use Sharpie on the plastic bag, and you could draw the four sets of parallel lines.
Oh, yeah.
Bag itself, and then you can travel and go, or sometimes at craft stores you can do the same thing, like with a little drawstring canvas bag, and again you could get a ruler and draw your parallel lines for your tic-tac-toe grid, and you could do that. You could do paper, you could do cardboard, because all you're doing is you're just placing the rock on whatever it is, so the material doesn't really matter. You can get creative with it in a lot of different ways. If you do decide to give it as a gift, it's really fun if you put everything in a bag and then you draw the grid on the tic-tac-toe grid on the bag itself. That would make a really fun little gift. Kind of a travel go tic-tac-toe board.
Yeah. Thank you for the ideas. That's great.
Hey, sure. Ben wants to show you his to the group. I'm going to make him spotlight him. Here's Ben. Oh, look. Chances. I wish Todd was on so he could see that. I think he just had to leave. He would love that, Ben.
Oh so. My gosh, Ben, that makes my heart so happy.
Wow.
Well done.
Perfect. Too bad.
Todd. I'm here. I see it, Ben.
You see it? Thank you.
I do.
Okay, there he was. And always has such good stuff about chances.
And Nicholas wants to show some rocks too.
Nicholas, let's see what you got, man.
Yeah, it's awesome.
It's a beautiful rainbow.
Rainbow rock. Oh,
oh my gosh. So cool.
Now we're going to have to lots of rocks.
Well,
look, it's all just hash.
Great, Nicholas.
Oh, and then she's got some too. Oh, look.
Oh, those are fun.
She's my great archer.
There's that word peace that Jessica was going to use. Look at the rainbow.
Mm-hmm.
Mine is about the box.
Now, Nicholas, can I ask you, where all did you guys find your rocks?
Yeah.
Oh, we went to a railroad track.
With a railroad track.
Oh.
Good idea.
Nice. Cool.
My heart.
Your heart?
Very nice. My heart. Does that.
Good deal.
Awesome. Abby, you want to share again?
My kindness rock.
Oh,
it has a cross and it says, "You matter."
Oh, Abby, that's beautiful. I see that. Wow. That's really beautiful, Abby.
My other ones is drying right now.
Your other ones are drying right now? Wise. Yeah. Yeah, that's a thing about rocks is they take a little, or a painting in general, takes a little bit of time because you got to let things dry and then you can add details and let things dry. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, it's a whole pattern. I'm running out of rocks that I gathered. So one of the things that I'm doing is I'm just finishing up my little tic-tac-toe set.
Okay.
Over here. Does anybody need me to re-show how I did anything?
I'm sure.
Jessica, do you have a question?
Looks good. Looks good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hey, look at these. My birthday props.
Nice.
Great.
Nice.
I get peanut rock, I get pink.
Jess, you're unmuted. Did you have a question for Liz?
How about blessings?
That's beautiful. I love it.
I'm thinking that.
That's a great kindness rock for sure.
Just asking.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Well, can you show me something?
Yeah, what do you want to see?
Can you guys can show me something? What I need to do next?
Okay, so have you put your base coat on your kindness rock?
Yeah, I'm doing that first, yes.
Okay, then if you just want to put the base coat on first, and then you can give it a minute to dry, and then you can decide on what details you want to do.
Okay.
Does that help? So I was going to add more detail to these guys, and I can re-show you how I did that. I got my base coat down.
Polka dots are easy. I like polka dots.
Mm-hmm. They're very easy. Polka dots and stripes. So you've got your base coat on each one of these guys.
Come at this.
Yeah.
Can I do like something like a wing or like a mermaid wing or like a mermaid? I'm thinking something what I use rocks for.
Okay. You can, yeah.
You have a garden at your house outside?
I don't, but this is my mother's, my parents. But I'm thinking about having a garden myself.
Yeah, you can save it for when you have a garden. Put it in your garden, put it along the edge.
Because I have a garden room, so yes.
Mm-hmm.
And so, Sally's coming over, and so I was thinking, I don't know what kind of color she likes, but she likes, I'm trying to do tropical colors, like something tropical, like a pine tree. Can you do a pine tree or something?
Yeah.
Tropical.
Well, a pine tree isn't tropical, but a, oh my goodness, a palm tree would be tropical. You could do kind of a brown base and some
tan. Like a tan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like a tan base. you go. Well, good deal, friends. We're almost at our time together. Does anybody else have any questions about kindness rocks or tic-tac-toe sets or anything else? It's been really fun to hang out with you guys.
Well, everyone is still painting, Liz. I mean, my goodness.
Honestly, that's one of the things I really like about painting rocks is there's a little bit of a meditative piece to it. And you just kind of get into the flow and you just start painting and the detail work is fun and it's a good time.
Yeah. Well, let me see. On Thursday, I was just looking at what we're having on Thursday. Kat is doing a class on Thursday and it's called Kat's Summer Party.
Woo!
And she's going to play games, science experiments, dance, Jesus, nature, a whole bunch of things. So Kat's going to do that at 3:00 on Thursday.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, it's awesome.
All right. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed today. I hope you keep painting.
Does everyone want to say thank you, Liz? Thank you for bringing us to rock painting today. It was fun. Wave goodbye to everyone. Thank y'all for coming. It was fun.
Bye. Thank you.
Take all your rocks and have fun with them.
Bye, Hannah.
Bye, everyone. Great work today.
Work. Have fun. Have a great day. Mm-hmm. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Thank you, Liz.
Bye.
Thank you, Carla.
Bye.
Nikhil, can you come here and say goodbye? Come here. You got to come here. You got to look. I know you can see them, but they can't see you. You got to come over here. Come here. Come here. There you go.
Love it. I love it.
Now you say bye-bye.
Bye, Nikhil.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Nikhil.
Bye, Nikhil. Bye, Evan. Bye, Jess.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye,
everybody.
Bye, Leah.
I just went to
Hi, Abby.
Good to see you, yeah.
I see your hand, Luke. Cool, man. You see my hand?
Bye, Emily. Bye, Nancy.
Yeah.
Hey,
should we show our dirty hands, Nikhil?
Yeah. That was all awesome hands.
I want to say thanks for having us on.
Welcome.
Hi, Nicholas.
You are so welcome. Bye, you.
This is the thing you like about Zoom is seeing yourself, isn't it? Okay, go ahead. All right, go ahead. We're done. I can't turn it off though until you get up.
Okay, I'm ending. I'm cutting it off.
Okay. All right. Thank you, everybody. That was fun, Liz.
All right. You're welcome.